talking about intuition and revelation. Revelation, intuition. I have a question.
About intuition?
No, we've done a bit of that in Indian philosophy. We've read about intuition and revelation.
And it's okay to use that
absolutely,
word?
Absolutely. I think it's part of the creative process. It's a word which has otherwise been deep. Yes, of course. If we did it in critical theory and say, I intuitively feel this way, I mean, that's a problem. But then you're not doing critical theory.
No, but there's informed intuition. Yeah.
I think you've got to prepare yourself for things to happen to you.
Of course.
And therefore, there's a lot that you have to leave behind before you're able to even receive.
Yeah.
So how do you become a receptacle is, I think, more of a big challenge. But my question was a little more asking you is that at one level, you're talking about things happening to you, but at another level, you're also doing... You're also looking at factories. I know what happened when you were looking at factories.
Sorry, one second. Yeah. Sorry. Can we just keep the projector on? I just thought...
Yeah, you found something?
No, I was just going to play some images.
Oops.
In this projection.
Okay.
And we would keep talking. We could keep the lights on. Just...
Okay.
Something.
Ambient?
Not ambient.
Yeah? Okay, no, okay.
Anyway, just something. Sorry.
So my question is that how do you reconcile moments of this sort of deep impact as well as searching and all of that? How do you reconcile it with when you get a commission to photograph a factory, for instance? What happens then? I mean...
You want me to tell the Rahul Bajaj story?
No, well, it's up to you. You tell them whatever story you want, but it's important. No, because it's an important part of your oeuvre, whoever, whatever, wherever. But the thing is that you have gone down that route as well. I mean, there is this route where people would like to have you come and photograph their plant, their office, I mean, whatever it may be. It's a commission. But it's this kind of commission. Where it's not your chance so much that'll have a role.
But it did. Yeah. And what a chance. My God.
So what happened?
So I was doing an assignment for Fortune magazine. I had stopped doing commissions for a long time. This was really an exception because it was Fortune wanting me to photograph business families in India. And I thought that could be very interesting for me. And I was... always interested in family portraits. So I went off to Pune and went to meet Mr. Rahul Bajaj, sent him privacy in advance so he would know a little bit about me so there was no surprises. And I went and I laid out all my equipment a little bit like this, you know, all my cameras. I don't work like that. I work very small and on my own. But somehow I felt I had to really play the photographer there. And so... lots of cameras, light stands that I wasn't going to use, but just to have there. So he comes, he's a very tall man. I'm, as you know, very small. And hello, Mr. Bajaj. And he shakes my hand and he says, hello, Dayanita, thank you for your book. Where is your photographer? So I said, Mr. Bajaj, I sent you the book. I'm the photographer. So, and I've got my Hasselblad here. And beautiful, beautiful Hasselblad. So he's tall like this, and I'm sort of like where Shireen is. And he says, you are going to take my picture with that antique camera? I said, Mr. Bajaj, this is the Rolls Royce of cameras. It's the most beautiful camera, and trust me, I really know what I'm doing. So don't worry about that. Because he didn't expect to see a woman. And then he called Fortune magazine and said, you know, I'm Rahul Bajaj, and you've sent this little lady photographer to take my picture. So they said little lady photographer is very difficult to get. She was agreed with great difficulty, and she's the best. We could have sent anyone, but for this, she's the best. So then I was going to take the picture. But then his grandchildren hadn't come back from school. And a daughter-in-law had to go some with families, it's always like that. But I was already a little annoyed with him because, you know, this was... I thought this lady photographer and all was not on. And then he said, okay, now I don't know when the children will come. Why don't you go and see my factory? And I said, Mr. Bajaj, I'm not a factory's photographer. I'm a family portrait photographer. And then I was quite embarrassed because I thought, why am I giving this man attitude? You know, he's made these lovely scooters his whole life. And they're so romantic, the idea of the Vespa. So, okay, so I'll go and see his factory. And sort of with a very surly expression, went off to go and see his factory. And I was quite a sort of diva in my field by now, you know. It wasn't like, this was just about 5-6 years ago, 2006, 2007. Yeah. So it's not like I was so unknown. Very, very annoyed with him, went off to see the factory, went into, I don't know what it's called, where all the 10,000 scooters. My jaw dropped open. I had never been inside a factory. It was like seeing, I don't know, the Taj Mahal on a full moon night for the first time, something like that. And I did a whole project on factories because of Mr. Bajaj's grandchildren being late
from school
and my having to go and see his factory. So that's an incredible chance. And I don't know how much my part is, how much life does, how it happens, but it happens sort of again and again. My part is that I grab it.
Mm. You recognize it.
Yeah.
You recognize something special and then you're not going to let go.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Absolutely. Same with the conversation.
Yeah, with conversations as well. Yeah. And people.
Yeah, people, absolutely.
Yeah. Big, big, big part of your life.
Totally, right? Totally.
What little I know of you.
Absolutely.
Any questions? I mean, I could go on with her. We know each other fairly well, and I know a lot that we could talk about, but I don't think it's very fair, and I'm sure there are others who would like to converse with her as well. Yeah, can you just hold on, Saloni? Let him get the mic, please.
So, I don't know.
It's okay, it's on.
Okay. So, hi. So, you obviously liked the fact that your Museum of Chance is, you know, your dream has come true. But I, and it is, it has
come. But there's another dream already.
One of your dreams has come true. And obviously it was displayed in a way that you felt you worked best or you liked your works to be portrayed best because you like seeing multiple images at the same time.
I can't see properly. But, I'll shut this. We can put it off.
At your opening or at some point while the show has been on, and I have seen the show at MMB, what was the viewer's response to seeing works like this? Because obviously it's something new. I haven't seen this before. I've never heard of this. And actually literally was like, ye book niklega, and I was also trying to see if, you know, you could do this. I didn't know it was there was a photograph on the reverse.
You didn't buy one?
I don't like the number 352. Sorry. Maybe a photograph, but not a book. For me, as of now. A few more years. But
this,
I wanted to know.
There are no photographs of this work.
Oh, okay.
Think about it.
Okay, so now coming to my question is, what was the viewer's response to this? Did you gauge that, or
how should I know? Ask the viewer.
No, did you want to know that?
I don't know. Amrita is here. People were quite excited, I think.
Okay. But you were satisfied in seeing the works in this?
You know, this will sound very arrogant, but
no, I mean, I'm...
One makes the work because you have to.
Yeah.
I do not think about the viewer. If they appreciate it, it's a wonderful bonus. If they don't, what can I do? Because I have to do it. I have to put that work out there. I have to make those structures and put the book there. It's possible that nobody liked it. It's possible that everybody left saying that I wish we had seen prints. I don't think that was the case, though.
No, there were many when I went there who also picked up the book. So I don't think that was the case.
But I think it's interesting to think about what we mean by the print now.
Yeah.
Because you see, when I made silver prints, that was something else. There was a silver print, and then you made a reproduction, and that became a book or a poster. Now we have a scan. Even my print, even my analog negatives get scanned. So it's the same scan that makes a digital print, that makes the book. I happen to like the quality of Steigl's offset very much.
Okay.
So I've just, the book is priced very low. because we're just starting with the idea of it. But I see it equal to a print. It's just that it's a much larger edition. So
that's another thing. Why 352?
Because one set is 44.
Yeah, and 44, 88. And 44. Yeah.
88 into 4.
Okay.
Because there's only a limited number of books, no?
Yeah.
And in the artist book realm, 330, 300 is quite an okay number. So I wanted to work within that. So unfortunately for you, 88 times 4 becomes 352.
Can we have the... Yeah. Shireen, just one. No. They won't be able to hear you at the back.
From this exhibition so far, how many gold bangles will you be able to make?
I think I'm going to have... Gold has come down.
So far.
Yeah, so far. At least 4. Maybe I'll need a longer arm. Maybe they'll come up to here. But I cannot tell you the pleasure of each bangle made out of my book sales.
You have a question? Yeah, one.
Hi. Dhananda, you mentioned that you don't like to number. I mean, you don't like to say when that picture was clicked. Hmm. But don't you think, I mean, for you, because you know about it, but, you know, as a viewer, I would like to know, you know, for me, when I see, say, if you number the picture, say, 1978, for instance, for me, then time stands still there. So I can relate to it. Okay, 78, this is what it was then. For you, because you have taken the picture, for you, maybe you know it so well. So why do you say that?
No, I don't want you to think of the time.
Why
not?
I do it
very purposely. I don't want you to think of the time. I don't want you to think of the geography. Because I believe there's something else, there's another magic that pictures can do. And the time, the where and the when really gets in the way. Later on, if I were to do a retrospective, there might be dates on things because historically it'll be important. Could be. But at this point, no, I'm trying to move photography into quite a different realm. And there, even page numbers would get in the way. Forget the date. So the books don't have page numbers, and I had to pay a customs duty on these books because they don't have page numbers, and therefore they said it's not a book.
I have, very clearly, when you started out and when you say that, you know, for you, like just now you explained to her, you said that when you work, for you, it's about whether you like it or not, you do it because you like it. But at the end of the day, isn't there some economics that is playing behind it? That you?
It's not that I like it. I have to do it.
Absolutely.
I just have to.
Hmm.
It's liking is too mild a word for that.
True.
You just have to do it. I have to build that. Even if I'm going to hurt my back, I have to carry that bag with me on that flight. I just have to do it.
So the economics, I mean, at the end of the day, there's an economics behind it. I mean, you have done it. Like, I mean, you're joking about that bangle. But that aside, isn't there, for you to sustain this, there is an economics behind it. So doesn't that come into play when you say that?
Very much. Of course, economics is not something to be disregarded.
Hmm.
But economics can be balanced beautifully, no? There's the high and the low.
True.
So there's the museums, or there are just a few silver prints, and there's a certain kind of economics there, a very substantial economics there, and there's the books, which is actually, you know, costs me more than, you know, what you pay for it doesn't even cover all the costs that are involved. But I want to build this up. And one day, I hope in my lifetime, the book will be at least here. Because I really, we just don't have a word. We have to find that, what are we going to call that form? What are we going to call that space? It's not a gallery, it's not a publishing house. But it takes a lot from the gallery, it takes a lot from the publishing house. What's the third space going to be? What's this book object going to be? So right now I'm calling it a book object. But as the edition of this even goes up, I would like very much if the whole thing pays for itself. But for every aspect of it, you know?
Mm.
So, of course the price will go up. In Delhi, it's not going to be at this price.
Mm.
But it's not going to become like my prints.
Mm.
But I would like this is my work. So why would you not, if you want to collect my work, and I don't know if I'm sort of making a book out of fabric, you're going to say it doesn't have value because it's... So the economics part is actually a very long conversation. I think about it a lot. It's a very important part of what I do. I'm not foolishly just having these grandiose ideas of... There's a good plan in place. Mm-hmm.
And what happens when somebody, I mean, when you put in so much of, I mean, your heart is in everything that you have done. And as you said that, you know, you said that it doesn't matter. If you didn't like it, I'm okay with it. But at the end of the day, I mean, there is something about it that, you know, when someone says, ah, it's okay. I mean, when you face that, or have you faced it? Has anyone had the
guts? All the time. And then every time I do something, people say, oh, but I loved your blue book. What are you doing in Dream Villa? Oh, I loved Go Away Closer. Why are you doing this color?
So does that affect your creativity the next time?
Not at all.
No.
Can't listen to that. Otherwise, that's mediocrity, no? Sure recipe for mediocrity. Very important. I learned that very early on from Zakir and from other people that you have to be very careful who you listen to. So I've always chosen those people very... They're there. I'm not on my own orbit only. Mm. There are people I pay very, very... But I listen to everything. Walter was one of them. If I've got a full book in place and he tells me it's all shit, I wouldn't do it.
There are people like that even today who will critique it for you?
Yeah. There's two or three.
And then what do you do? Then you will change it, is it? Or will you...
It doesn't quite get to that point with them because they're also involved in the going... And it's in response to them. It's in response to conversation. Mm-hmm. So it's unlikely that I'll take something to Gerhard that he says he doesn't want to publish. Because we both have an idea of where we want to take the book. And there's also, with Gerhard it's different. He also just trusts me. He, you know, that file room book was like, I just had this idea that I want the colors to be different or I don't want text. But look what happened, and now we make Museum of Chance. And he said, okay, in file room you had black on the side. And this is not good because in the bookshops, nobody can see the spine. Mm. So I said, we can have gold, Gerhard. He said, no, we can't have gold. I said, yes, we can have gold. So he came to Frankfurt. The gold works very well. But there's not a situation, because of the ongoing conversation, no? Mm. It's not like I have a conversation and then I come back 6 months later and say, here's the work. The few conversations that I have are continuous, ongoing conversations. And with one or two people, they are daily conversations, which leaves room for very little else.
You never had to trash anything. Even as somebody who grew from that to what you are now, you never had to trash any of your work. I'm not asking about now. At 18 when you met Zaki, for instance, from then, you never had to trash any work. On your own.
See, I couldn't trash it. I had these negatives.
True.
So I couldn't cut up the negatives, and thank God I couldn't trash my work. Of course, there were lots of times. Go Away Closer is made entirely out of what I used to think were my dud pictures. So, but because it was analog, I had it all. And even now, just as I was leaving and finding all these things, I found some contact sheets and I said, Arey, I need this for Kochi, and now there's really no time because now Kochi is opening in 2 weeks or something. But I've given them for scanning, and that was the person calling me just before we started the talk. Negative, mein kuch problem hai. It's sort of never ending. The trashing part, that's what I worry about with digital, you know? That we trash so easily. Even on my phone, I trash so easily. And you just, if I had been trashing for these last 30 years, how much work I would have missed out. Blue Book was entirely a mistake. That factory picture that I started to take. I was shooting in color. I was on top of a very high tower, shooting in black and white. And I was, I ran out of black and white film, so I had to use color film, which was in my bag because it was a commission. And so I said, okay, let me just use this for now, and I'll change it when I'll make it black and white when I go to Delhi. When the film came from the lab, it was all blue. So I called the lab and I said, "Aapne kya kar diya?" And they said, "We've done exactly as we always do, normal processing, no push, no pull. I said, ye sab blue kaise ho gaye? Because I was not a color photographer. I was using daylight film after sunset. So it made the work blue. And I said, this is amazing. This is the way I'm going to shoot the factories. So I only shot in that blue light. And that's how I found, I think, sort of like a color palette of my own for the factories. Another chance.
Yeah.
Just. Hello. You said your show just now is
a yeah, I didn't.
No, there's one display copy.
Yeah.
See, it's the same book.
Yeah, yeah.
So you don't have to pull out each one. But you can buy a book right there. You didn't buy one?
No. It took me some time to figure out that was an actual book. I went in.
But we made a store inside the exhibition. That's the point of it. You could buy the full exhibition. All 88.
What happens is that when you have a brand new, a different paradigm.
Sorry? You know,
it's a different paradigm. It's not something that one's accustomed to. So you don't know. You don't know how to. You just don't know how to view it. You don't know how to receive it.
Huh.
It's just that's where the problems are. I mean, one is of viewing and receiving it. So as a spectator or somebody, even as somebody who loves a work of art, you just don't know how to deal with it because it's a totally new paradigm. And which is what's going to take a while to establish. And then you're going to have a different lexicon for it. That's what's going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
And that lexicon is being formed, and which is why it's so important. And thank God you're being filmed. You know what this is going to be 20 years down the line? It's going to be so important because this is like a historic moment that what you're doing is talking about it, it's like a state formation, you know, something which is happening.
Mm.
And you don't know it's happening because you're in the midst of it. It's only when it's happened, and then 5 years down the line, you say, gosh, I was there, I was hearing it all, but it didn't make sense.
Mm.
And then it's going to make sense because it's going to be a lot more written about it. You'll have curators, you'll have critics, you'll have historians, a lot of people writing about it. And then there's going to be a literature, and the literature, once it's formed, it then gets disseminated and taught, and like people like us will discuss it and talk about it, and that's how it gets accepted. It's a brand new lexicon, and which is why it becomes hard for people. I mean, I can understand your problem.
Buy it, you can pull it out all the time.
She'll get her glass, she'll get her gold bangles. That's what. Jaya.
Did you really miss that?
It was like, you know, it's like a library. I mean,
it's possible. I mean, we could keep gloves because I wouldn't want people to. Yeah. And I think we can think about it. I don't know if Amrita is still here. It's possible because it's. That's also the point of it, that it's not so fragile, that I don't need so much insurance for this, that it can go through Gati. I don't need Star necessarily to be shipping it, you know? That it takes care of a lot of insurance and shipping problems as well, which Shireen should appreciate. No? How much that's part of our problem?
Of course, with any. One more question.
Just to go back to...
Jaya Lauda.
Yeah, just to go back to the idea that you don't want to date your pictures, that you like the back and forth movement, that you like revisiting places and people. Are you looking at the concept of timelessness in your work? Is that important to you? I was just wondering.
You're collapsing time.
Yeah, definitely. I don't know about the word timelessness, because that sounds very profound and all that. But I did mention dissolving chronology.
Which is
why I'm going. Yeah. No, very much, very much. And because the same photograph, there's the new Parquet magazine. Do you know, are you familiar with Parquet magazine? It's a wonderful Swiss magazine that makes special editions. And so I'm doing the next special edition for them. Which is, okay, I won't talk about that now. But anyway, in that, there is a great piece. As soon as it's printed, I'll send that out to the group, written by James Lingwood, about my girl on the sleeping bed picture and how she keeps reappearing in every exhibition of mine in different places. Because she's so central to what I do. So just because the edition of that image is over, I can't stop showing it.
It becomes a motif. It's a leitmotif.
Yeah.
In a particular work when it keeps recurring. And there is, it's recurring because that's part of your...
Like in the Kochi work, there's a lot of files and archives and libraries and archivists. So you could sort of say, oh, she's done file room and now again. And probably that is what people will say. But what can I do? I can't resist one of those rooms full of paper. It's like a sensual experience for me. Yeah. I have to photograph it. And then if I like the image, I put it out. And, you know, I don't know. I've sort of, I'm quite, I think because I understand that one does what one does because one has to do it. So it's fine. What can I do if nobody likes it, no?
Nothing. Yeah, the last one. We'll just take the last question. I think the
photography is great, okay, and so is your books. I'll tell you something. You're a very good salesperson.
I was waiting for something like that from you. Trust a photographer to always...
Yeah, but you know, it's good to listen to that. It's nice to say that, hey, a photographer may not be a good salesperson. It's important because it's your book. You're going around and doing that for your photographer.
Thank you.
Is there any other questions that we have here? No? Well, we've got a whole lot of our students who are there at the back who want to meet up with you, several of them. And they're all waiting to talk
lovely.
To you.
I have something and, special for the students.
Yeah, but just before we get into that, I just had one little announcement, if I may. Just to tell you some of the forthcoming programs for the coming month of December. On the 11th of December, we have... Then the author, Geeta Hariharan, speaking on her new book called Almost Home, Cities and Other Places. On the 16th of December, we have Leslie Pullen speaking on sculptures of Java, 9th and 14th century, deciphering the textiles. 18th of December, James Olas and Armando Migueles, staring at the viewers, Frida Kahlo and self-portraiture in Mexico. So you're welcome, and it's all open to the public, and it's free. I got a call today to wonder if they had to pay, and as I've kind of felt, I said, well, not if you're not teaching. So you're welcome, and in the meanwhile, come and meet our staff for the evening, and for a long time to come, and thank you so much, Anita,
thank you.
Finding the time.
I'm quite embarrassed.
No, nothing. Just a little something for you. It's a book
thank
from
you.
Us.
Yeah. I'll make a special cover for it.
Yeah, oh, it's up to you. It's just, but I think she has something particular for all our students, so please come across.
Yeah, that we should put. Ah, yes, lovely.